Welcome to Microsoft Virtual Academy. I'm Brandon Matherson, and I'm on the Windows Server System Center and Azure Data Center Solutions team focused on helping customers better deploy services more efficiently across their data center. And that data center could lie on premises, in the cloud, or even with service providers, but we want to provide a more efficient solution for them to be able to do so. So one of the things we're thinking about is IT service management. What does this mean, and how do we bring in our ITIL processes into the mix when we think about our stack top to bottom when managing a data center? One of the pieces that we're going to cover now in this topic is going to be all about standardizing service delivery. And we want to make sure that we have a holistic view and seamless way to bring in all the processes and deliver it in a repeatable fashion for users within the environment. So let's dive into what this looks like and why do we actually care? What does consistent delivery of services mean, and what makes it valuable? Well, it's the idea that we have this service catalog which surfaces the standardized set of offerings that IT is going to deliver. When we do that, it enables the self-service users to make requests on demand and have confidence that those solutions are going to be spun up or provisioned as expected, on time, and without error. So that's one of the big attributes, and that we're going to use templates and workflows and processes and the CMDB within Service Manager to be able to do that. And what happens is IT at that point is then able to provide those services in an easy to find fashion. They're able to reduce the errors when those service requests are applied and we provision the environment as we expected. We increase efficiency and we improve reliability. In turn, that helps IT to really shine and really become more efficient and more agile as the demands grow or as the environment scales. So standardizing this process or standardizing service delivery process is all about the services and their request offerings. That's where IT is coming in and building out. If you look on the left, I have a number of different examples of request offerings. I want to request a new VM. I want to request to extend a VM, or I want to decommission a VM. When I do that, I can use a request template to do that. That template is the same. This form is going to help us to be able to deliver the same thing every time that this request offering comes up. So I can apply cost and SLA information to it, knowledge articles, so that my users really understand where to best do this, what to best do next, as well as all the prompting and input values that I want to apply to this. Next is the idea of automating this process. If I extend it over into the processes, I think about who does this need to be assigned to. Who needs to be notified? Who needs to approve this? And the systems that are automated with, let's say, taking advantage of Orchestrator helps us to be able to take all of that process or policies into account. And so how do we get there? We're going to do this with using the self-service portal with Service Manager. We're going to take advantage of the service catalog, which surfaces on that portal. And in the back end, that's all about the Service Manager CMDB or configuration management database and orchestrator using the runbooks to be able to bring this to light. So let's build a comprehensive service catalog. And there's three quick pieces that we want to talk about is the offerings themselves. The service offerings are the categories. That's what IT is going to be delivering at a high level. This is how I'm going to actually deliver and deploy my services. I have a set of information that I want to capture, and I can tie a multitude of what we call request offerings. Request offerings are the smallest amount of offering, or let's call this the elemental data that I want my users to be able to request, where IT enables the business unit users to make this request against the catalog. So that will be the actual VM that I want to have updated, or that I want to request, or that I want to have provisioned. When I do that, I have some data that will be prompted for me to be able to get that information, and then I can kick out some activities in the back end using my orchestrator runbooks to be able to do that. Lastly, what happens is I use my request templates to be able to automate these tasks, but then it helps the service catalog show up on the portal. And I'll take a look at that portal in a moment in terms of what that looks like. And here's an example of where you may see a list of items, and these are the actual request offerings that are available under that service offering. In this case, it's a private cloud infrastructure services. And then I have additional data that's prompting the user to go ahead and enter some information. So the three pieces of this are going to be the service offerings, the request offerings, and then the service request templates that help us to be able to map the appropriate next steps. What are those steps? At a high level, I take my work items that are being used to identify the standard information that I want to use in my service offering. I then bring in my request offerings, which is basically the set of IT approved services that they're going to be allowed to be able to provision. And then I use templates to be able to bring in those values or that data input mechanism that's going to be standardized every single time. And all that gets spits out into my service catalog. So I'm going to create the service offering, create the service request template. I'm going to publish that offering. I'm going to then create my service my request offering, publish that request offering, and then make sure that I continue to build on that within the catalog. And I can continue to add more and more over time as I need to, because I find out, oh yeah, under the private cloud offering or under the incident management offerings, I have more tasks that I want my users to be able to request because I found more issues that come up or they're demanding additional flexibility within that suite. So it's in this. One thing I want to call out here is that When I see a service offering and it shows up, it provides a consistent delivery of service related details. That can be those knowledge articles, that can be the service level agreement information, or even costing and charging information that I want to input or provide information about as well. And so the easy step here, I just create that offering. I go to that general tab and I start to input all the necessary information built within the catalog. And we'll take a look at these work items in a moment when we step into Service Manager. When I look at my templates, I see my request template. And this is where I standardize how I'm going to apply the automated tasks or the runbook activities that I want to apply to be able to provide the necessary information for that request. And when I do that, I'm in within the Service Manager console, again, those work items where I have a template section where I can create that template and update that form and provide the activities that I want to actually perform for that particular request. So this takes away the idea of a person manually going to each one of these environments or each one of these consoles, or let's say if they need to provision a VM, what are all those steps? I'm doing them in an automated fashion. So then a request offering will then provide that mapping of user responses, right? That's where the user is prompted for specific information. What's the name of that VM? What is the size of that VM? What do you want to do with that VM once you have it? And that's where the request offering gets down into those minor details that are critical for ownership and who is that applied to. And again, I apply my users, my role-based information to this environment, helps me be able to define and map this when I want to think about my chargeback scenarios. So again, I'm going to create that offering. I'm going to go into that general information and start to input all of the user prompting, configure those prompts, and then make sure I publish that. And once I do that, I can see it within the portal once that user goes in and logs in. So when that happens, I now have a deployed service from beginning to end. And that's everything that we've just talked about that helps us be able to map that service offering to one or more request offerings. And again, it doesn't have to be one or two or three. It can be as many as you like, as customized as you like for a given scenario. And you can create a full list of request offerings and decide who gets access to which offerings under which categories. So if I think about the process or the scenario, I have my request templates and my request offerings all going into my service offerings, which are surfaced on my portal, where I can, for instance, provision VMs, expand cloud capacity, or resolve some problems or incidents, because sometimes I'm going to have some requests to fix some problems that have occurred. That could be brought in through the self-service experience where a user has provided that, or again, with Orchestrator, I may have already created an automated runbook that brought in data from Operations Manager when an alert was kicked off, and that alert automatically created an incident. And that incident went into this process and created this experience as well. And you'll see it. You'll see a number of different categories. In this case, this category you'll see where I have my data center cloud resources, or I have, or cloud services, or I have my private cloud infrastructure services. Either one, and they both render a set of secondary tasks or request offerings that may exist there. And they may look like this in a form of 1, 2, 3, a number of different things that can be as long as you need them to be. So a service offering is made up of those request offerings. That's the basic premise here that we're building on when we think about our cloud experience or self-service experience for users. Now, what helps us do this is our cloud service process pack. That's another one that's really cool when we think about our on-premises cloud infrastructure and being able to provision and provide the system center capabilities brought to you through Service Manager and Orchestrator. And this is something that you can download as an add-on. You'll have this to take with you once you get your hands on the materials for this course. And then you can build this into your environment. Next, you'll have a set of onboard tenants. You want to make sure you subscribe to the necessary cloud resources. And you want to provision VMs against those resources, or against those subscriptions, I should say. And that's the process for how we would actually deploy or work through the cloud service process pack. So let's take a look at what this looks like within Service Manager. Before we continue, we want to go see hands-on what this looks like for within your environment. So I'm going to go into Service Manager, and I'm going to open up the module for all my work items. I want to see what my work items look like. Okay, so here I am within Service Manager. I'm in the console, and the first place that I want to go to is the library, and you'll see right here on the left. When you do that, you'll see the service catalog. This section here is where I now have all the information. You'll have a top view or overview of all of the offerings or request offerings that may exist in a group. I can also get information around all the activities, so forth and so on. So I have a bunch of request offerings that I've already created. I'm going to scroll down and just go to some common tasks that I've already have created. And let's say I have update a virtual machine. That's one of the request offerings that I have. I'm going to open this. Okay. So once I do this, I'm inside the actual template for editing, or if I created this, I could have created this from scratch, where I came in and I have a template that I want to apply to updating a virtual machine service request. I have my service request template. I have some information about this user prompts. I need to prompt my users for basic information about this offering. The title of the offering, the urgency, I need to identify what the virtual machine is, and then some other information about what type of activity I want to do. I want to change ownership, or perhaps I want to decommission a VM or whatever the case may be. I want to make sure that I publish it. I can also apply some knowledge articles to this if I choose to. Perhaps you have a lot of rich information that already exists within your environment today. You want to bring that in. You can definitely do that here and point to that information and use it. So that's my request offering. Let me cancel this out. And now I go to my top level category, or that grouping, which is called the service offerings. And again, you'll see these same titles that we just saw when we were going through the slides. You have data center cloud service. You have private cloud infrastructure services. Let me go look at private cloud infrastructure services. When this opens, I'll see, again, some general information. I can define the category that I want this pointed to. And again, you'll see this under general, or I can have it under account management. I can have it under IT service management. I chose general for this particular offering. This is how it resonates or surfaces on the actual self-service portal itself. I have some detailed information. If I so choose, I want to enter that. I may have some related services that I want to apply to it. Knowledge articles that I can apply to it, or the request offerings themselves. In this one, I have a numerous request offerings that I've already applied. And these are the same ones that we just looked at. And I had update a virtual machine. You'll notice it sitting right there. That particular request offering is tied to this service offering. So that's what I wanted to do. I wanted to make sure that it's published, it's there, I'm ready to go. Okay. Now, we also talked about the templates. The templates were a great mechanism for us to have a standardized process for actually getting information into the request offering and ultimately into the actual service offering, so that when users go into the portal, they click into the necessary request, and then it kicks off the automated task in the back end. So let me take a look at one of the templates, and we'll look at what is that automated process that we brought in. And again, this is the automated task or workflow that we saw within Orchestrator. So when I click on templates, I'll see a number of templates. There's numerous amounts of templates that we've already created that we've used over time. So when I do that, let's say I want to take a look at a particular template that I've created, and it's called release phase. So in this particular one, I have some information about this, and I can click OK, and it loads the form, and I can identify a set of tasks or a set of activities that have been attached to it. And this helps me be able to identify some incident information or conduct a final security review in this particular case. However, I want to go create my own, and I'm going to just go ahead and step out of this. And I want to look at what is going to be requested of me when I come in and create one. I want to create one request. I want to make this a service request. I want to make sure when I go in and create this template, I want to make this a service request offering. And while it loads here, we're going to see service request there. I want to click service request and click OK. Oh, looks like I missed it. Service request, click OK. When I do that, I'm now going to open up my form. Once I hit OK, I'll open up a form. And here I am. I'm going to be asked for some basic information, affected users. I have my administrators in this particular case. Request template. Again, I want to apply some urgency, some priority to this as well. And then I want to look at activities. Activities are where now I start to bring in the actual runbook information or the steps or the tasks that I want to make sure that I get assigned to this. So when I click activities, I've created some runbook automation templates, and I've already created that are in here. And default review activity. Let's say I want to take a look at this one. And what has happened here, perhaps I wanted to expand some cloud capacity, or I wanted to perform some additional steps within my environment on an existing activity that I've already created. I want to come in and apply this particular form. So once I do that, I can then apply some more information about it. I being asked for some information, some basic description information, and I'm done. Okay. So that's how we use templates to be able to apply to service request or request offerings, and then use those request offerings for service offerings that are surfaced on the self-service portal within Service Manager. But let me quickly take a look at what does it look like from a user's perspective. I've now went into Service Manager in the console. I've done all those steps as a service admin. Now let me change hats. I'm now a Contoso user. So let me step into what I'll see when I go to the portal. When I'm in the portal, here's what I'll see. And I'll see my service catalog or the self-service experience portal. And I want to scroll down and I want to take a look at, you'll see this general tab. I'll go into private cloud infrastructure resources. The next thing I want to do, I still want to request a virtual machine. I need some resources, so let me do that. I'll click on request a virtual machine. I'll see a request form on the top right, and now I have a title for that service request. Now you're seeing the same parameters that we saw when we were inside the request offering. They're now being surfaced directly within this portal on this site here. So now let me apply a title to this. I have some urgency that I've defined for this. I have some cloud resources subscription that I've already created, and I want to make sure that I'm connected here, so I click that particular resource. I want the name of that VM. If I have some additional description for that, I have it there as well. I want to go next. How many VMs do I want to have created? And then I also want to make sure that I apply the appropriate VM template that may be available, and I see one here for an older version of SQL, let's say, with SQL on it. I do that. I need to ensure that I'm connected to the appropriate network, because I want to make sure that I have connectivity once that VM is up and running. It's here. And then I click Next. I want to make sure that I am the appropriate user. And I have information about my request prior to submitting it. I hit submit, and I've kicked off that request, and all of the automation in the backend has already started, has already begun working, and the appropriate approvals, notifications, and fulfillment is already starting to occur within my environment. I can then see my request at any point in time. When I come back to my portal, I'm able to see which requests are still pending, where I am in the process. IT can update that request as they so choose, and I'm able to get that information as I need it. So that's the process of using the service catalog to render a self-service experience for your customers. So let's step back to the presentation here. So what have we covered here? We've really talked about how we're using self-service and the richness of the service catalog within Service Manager to deliver experience to customers. Now let me think about why would I do this so that you can walk away with an application or scenario where you can put this in your own environment. When you have resources that are built within your infrastructure, For instance, you want to be able your users to request clouds, request capacity, raise incidents, manage their status, or manage and maintain application resources, which resource are you going to use and which self-service experience would you expect to walk through? And that's when you have that service management experience in your environment, or those processes or that approval and policies that you've built so much investment into, and you don't want to lose that with your on-premises environment, use a self-service experience with Service Manager. When you have some environments that you want to manage for your application teams or for your teams, I then want to leverage App Controller to be able to spin up those environments and manage those environments as I need to. And that's how we would see a service delivery experience working from a self-service perspective with the self-service catalog through Service Manager and Orchestrator as well as App Controller. So I hope this has been helpful. This is one great way for you to take advantage of some of this experience that we've been talking about today. But I want you to go into TechNet Download Center, the Eval Center, and download System Center 2012 R2, and specifically Service Manager, and get your hands on it and start to play with it. Also take advantage of our TechNet Virtual Labs. We've created a number of unique scenarios and a self-paced environment for you to go play with this online and evaluate how you would actually do this if you were to start doing this within your environment. And lastly, I definitely hope that you would come back to Microsoft Virtual Academy and continue to learn more about our System Center 2012 R2 capabilities, and I'll be delivering more around the IT service management moving forward. So please come back. My name is Brandon Matheson, and thank you for coming.